It takes a lot of courage to leave the life you have known and begin chasing your dreams.
16 years ago, Jim and Wendy Allen left their jobs here in Sioux Falls after deciding they wanted to do something different.
Well, they ended up in Independence, Missouri, becoming the caretakers of a historic home, working harder than they ever had before. I had a chance to see it for myself a few weeks ago and to hear about what they learned here in Sioux Falls that has led to their success. The math might not add up right away. We left Sioux Falls and drove 374 miles to Independence, Missouri to talk about Sioux Falls.
So many wonderful thoughts. We don't have a bad memory of Sioux Falls. We really don't.
Jim Allen really liked living in Sioux Falls.
And the people there were wonderful.
Jim loved visiting the Corn Palace and Chamberlain and the Black Hills, but something was missing. In fact, that something had been missing long before he moved to Sioux Falls, and it was something he just couldn't shake.
I wanted to be involved in a business that would succeed or fail based upon my efforts.
And it was that desire that eventually brought Jim and his wife Wendy to Independence, Missouri, and this stone mansion built in 1900. Neither had a connection to this house or this city, but when they saw this place, they knew they had found what they were looking for.
The house was meant to be shared. And so when people come in, I think it's reflected in Wendy's and my hospitality, is we want you to feel comfortable in a home.
You see, that something that Jim and Wendy always wanted to do was run their own bed and breakfast, something that would be their own business, but would also be personal and personable. For the last 11 years, they have welcomed guests from all over the United States here at the Hawthorne Bed and Breakfast.
Most of the guests that stay in bed and breakfasts are familiar with bed and breakfasts. They come for the uniqueness of it. They don't want the commercial hotel. They don't want the sterile kind of environment.
The clientele has increased here year to year, but what has also boosted business recently is the popularity of Downton Abbey.
And that was reflected in a lot of the weddings that we hosted here. A lot of them wanted those vintage-type weddings and that sort of thing, which is fun.
But all the success Jim and Wendy are having here also has a Sioux Falls connection. When Jim lived in Sioux Falls, he worked for Sioux Valley Health System.
Sioux Valley, now Sanford Health, treated people properly and correctly. And there was a basic belief there in how people should be treated.
And Jim says when he was building his business plan for a bed and breakfast in Western Missouri, he used as a model what he had seen and experienced at a hospital in Eastern South Dakota.
And I think that just reinforces to me that there were organizations and are organizations, and it reflected how I wanted people being treated.
Jim and Wendy are both natives of Vermont, but it is clear that when they left Sioux Falls, they left a part of themselves here, but they took a part of Sioux Falls with them. Yeah, it's paying off. Hotels.com recently awarded the Hawthorne Bed and Breakfast a rating of 4.8 out of 5, one of the highest bed and breakfast scores in the entire Midwest.